Nothing's on my team today. Luna, you're my team. Let's do this. Hey everyone, today I am finally doing a video that I've talked about doing so many times and a million of you have requested. It is my top five nudie, kind of mauve-y, everyday lip colors. If you subscribe to my channel, you probably already know these are my like go-to lip colors. I have five different lip colors that I'm gonna show you today. They're all some form of lipstick, and then bonus, I have four different lip liners I'm also gonna show you because that's an important part of the lip creating process, right? But it's also kind of an extra step in my mind, even though it can do a lot for you. So if you wanna skip it, that's not my business. I often skip it as well, no judging. There are a couple colors I've talked to you about a million times and others not so much, some drugstore, some high end. But these are all just kind of my legit top five of the moment. Don't lock me into these, my favorites are always changing. A lot of these have stuck around for a long time though. Enough intro, I know. Let's look at the lip colors. First up, a lip color probably a lot of you guys were expecting to be in this countdown. It is Maybelline's Warm Me Up. It's a drugstore lipstick. I just happened on this one by accident and completely fell in love with it. I repurchased it. It's kind of a more pinky nude. It's definitely on the lighter side out of the colors that I have to show you. It's a cream finish. It's not long wearing. It's just easy to wear. I can throw it on with or without a lip liner. Of course, with a liner, you know, your lips have a little bit more impact, but by itself, it totally works. Next up, a newer product. This is the Revlon Ultra HD Matte Lip Color. I discovered this in December. The color name is Seduction and it is printed in like 0.25 font on the back. I don't know why they chose to do that. It really tripped me up when I used it in tutorials and stuff. This one is more of like a peachy nude. It comes off a little bit lighter than Warm Me Up, but it's more of a brownie peach color rather than a nudie mauve. It does set down to matte. It's not particularly long wearing. The only downside to this product for me, though I love the color, love the finish, is the scent. These have a tutti frutti, fresh and fruity kind of scent, and I don't like it. Some other people might like it, but be warned. But it does wear off, so if you can get through the initial like 30 seconds of putting it on your lips, you're good. And again, this is a drugstore product, so that's always nice because it's quite affordable. Next up, we have the Balm's Meet Matte Hues Long Lasting Liquid Lipstick in Committed. I think a lot of people have discovered the greatness of this color. It, again, is easy to wear. It's a long-wearing liquid lipstick, but for everyday use, I like a color that's closer to my lip color, like a My Lips But Better, which is basically all of these colors, because as it wears off, which it inevitably does, it will wear off in a more attractive, less noticeable way, which is nice because it can get gross. You know what I'm talking about. I don't want to say what other people say because it really grosses me out, but it's true. You know what I'm talking about? It's nasty. This color sets down to matte really quickly. Obviously, the Revlon HD is still not set down to matte, and this one's completely matte already. It's very close to the first two colors. It's almost kind of like a mix of the two, and it has a little bit more brown. So it's kind of like a peachy mauve-y nude all rolled into one, which could you ask for more? I don't think you can. I don't think you really need a lip liner with this lip color. You can definitely just put it on. It's not hard to put on as far as liquid lipsticks go. I did a full review on this whole line. I love like every single color, but this is definitely my favorite. For my fourth lipstick, I have Lola by Jouer. I believe this is the hydrating lipstick. It is quite hydrating. It is a traditional lipstick. It is a cream finish, and it is more sheer than the other colors I've shown you, and it's definitely on the lighter, kind of peachy side of things. It's what I have on my lips right now. It works really well with your natural lip color. I don't know if I can say that for everyone, but it works really well with my natural lip color. It doesn't feel heavy. It's super, super wearable. It kind of goes with whatever makeup that you're wearing because it is pretty nude, but it's not one of those like lighter than your lip color's nude, which never works for me. I never like it on myself. Even when I did the Tarte lip paints video and swatched every single one of them, every time I saw a comment that said that the super light, pale, almost concealer looking lip color looked good on me, I was like, you're crazy, you're crazy, you're all crazy. Which it could be something that's completely in my head, but personally, I think it looks awful on me. So nudes that are like this, it works for my face. In my heart, I don't know. And the last liquid lipstick I have is Kat Von D's Lolita, the original. I am prepared for some of you to kind of think that this one doesn't really belong in the group because it's a much darker, kind of more browny, mauvey color. But on my lips, it has the same feel. It's in the same color family. And I was totally late to this party, but I do think it belongs in this group. It is liquid lipstick, and I've already spoke my feelings about liquid lipsticks and how picky I am, but this one does make the cut. It does set matte. It is long wearing. I think it's kind of like a cult favorite. I got it at Sephora. I can't remember how much I paid, but it's not drugstore prices. I was gonna say affordable, but that's confusing, right? Moving on to the lip liners. I've actually kind of changed my mind. I'm only gonna share three with you. Okay, first off, you guys are definitely expecting this one. This is NYX's, that feels weird, Peekaboo Neutral. It is just a gorgeous, goes with anything, my lips but better kind of color. It's definitely mauve, but it's not too dark. It really kind of matches my lips almost exactly. The only troubling thing about that one is it's usually pretty hard to find, which is annoying. My next favorite lip liner is Charlotte Tilbury Lip Cheat in Pillow Talk. This one is a very similar color, but the consistency is very different. It's a little bit more pink than Peekaboo Neutral, and I don't know what it is. It's marketed as a pencil that is supposed to help you kind of correct your lips, like if you have asymmetry or if you want to overline your lips or something like that. And that is totally true. I don't know what it is about the formula, but when I use this and, you know, I overline my lips sometimes, but it's almost not even noticeable because I'm very cautious with it. But when I do it with this one compared to any other liner, it just works so much better. I don't know why, it just does. I feel like it's a little bit thicker, but it wears nicely. Swatch it, you'll understand. Next up, another drugstore product. This is the Milani Color Statement Lip Liner in number 04, All Natural. This one is definitely more of a brown shade. This would be a good color to go with Lolita. And it's drugstore, so if you go out on a limb, you're not out a lot, okay? Don't panic. All right, guys, so that's it for me. If you wanna see any more like top fives, I can totally do that. I have a lot of favorite products and I would love to compile them. If you'd like to see more of that, let me know down below. I'm always listening. Give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it or if you wanna see more like it or whatever. You can also find me on social media everywhere. It's Leanne Says. I'll put those links down below to make it easy for you to come say hey, because I like to talk to you. And please subscribe to my channel if you haven't subscribed already. And if you have, thank you so much. You are my people and I love you. And as always, thank you so much for watching and I'll see you guys next time. Bye everyone. It's Bubblicious. Pebbles Pony. Luna is growling at me. Why? Can we be friends for a second? Okay, maybe I'm being like cold-hearted and maybe slightly or completely forgetful, but I don't think I've ever had like an amazing Valentine's Day. There's always been something that's gone tragically wrong.